Hello everyone, welcome to the lecture on a STATCOM FEX controller. So up to now we learn about the series FEX controller, TCSC and SSSC. Now we started the SUN FEX controller. The SUN FEX controller, there are normally two types of SUN FEX controllers are there. One is the STATCOM and another one is the SVC. So SUN FEX controller is always connected at the midpoint of the transmission line or at the end of the bus, because one terminal of a SUN connected FEX controller is connected to the bus, and another one is a grounded. So in this lecture, we learn about the first STATCOM. STATCOM is a static synchronous compensator. So it acts as a voltage source behind a reactance. And the STATCOM has a fast response time because of converters are used. So it is also an SQLC. So STATCOM is a shunt connected reactive power compensation device that is capable of generating or absorbing the reactive power, and in which the output can be varied to control the specific parameters of an electric power system. So by controlling the voltage, you can control the reactive power by using the help of STATCOM. So it is in general a solid state switching converter, capable of generating or absorbing independently controllable real and reactive power at its output terminal. When it is fed from an energy source or energy storage device at its input terminal. We see the diagram of XM. From that you can understand this point. The voltage source converter that from a given input of DC voltage produces a set of three-phase AC output voltages, each in phase with and coupled to the corresponding AC system voltage through a relatively small reactance. Voltage source converter that from a given input of DC voltage produces a set of three-phase AC output voltages, each in phase with and coupled to the corresponding AC system voltage through a relatively small reactance. So this is a basic diagram of STATCOM. We can connect the STATCOM at the end of the bus, right? So it is a normally supply the voltage, so it will behave as a voltage source. So the STATCOM is a controller reactive power source. It provides a desired reactive power generation and absorption entirely by means of electronic processing of the voltage and current waveform in a voltage source converter. So by changing the magnitude order of a voltage and current of a converter, you can control the voltage or controlling the reactive power of a system. So this is your simple utility transmission line is there or bus is there. So if we connect the STATCOM like this one, so this is your DC supply source which supply DC voltage to the converter. That converter convert the DC to AC, and that AC is with the help of magnetic coupling, it is connected to the bus or midpoint of the transmission line. So here the mainly two types of analysis is said. STATCOM either supply the reactive power or absorb the reactive power. So if your STATCOM voltage, that means ES, is greater than ET, means ES is greater than ET, at the time the STATCOM supplies the reactive power into the system. Whereas in second condition, if the ES is less than ET, the voltage magnitude of ES is less than ET, at the time STATCOM absorbs the reactive power from the system. Absorbing or supplying the reactive power, it depends on the magnitude of a STATCOM voltage. So the exchange of reactive power between the converter and the AC system can be controlled by varying the amplitude of the three-phase output voltage ES of the converter, which is already shown in this figure. That if the amplitude of the output voltage is increased above that of the utility bus voltage ET, then a current flow through the reactance from the converter to the AC system, and the converter generates the capacity reactive power for the AC system. If the amplitude of the output voltage is decreased below the utility bus voltage, then the current flows from the AC system to the converter, and the converter absorbs inductive reactive power from the AC system. So if the output voltage equals to the AC system voltage, the reactive power Xn becomes a zero, in which case the STATCOM is said to be in a floating state, right? When the ET is equal to ES, right? So at that time, there is no supplying or absorbing the reactive power into the system. A STATCOM provides the desired reactive power by exchanging the instantaneous reactive power among the phases of the AC system. The mechanism by which the converter internally generates or absorbs the reactive power can be understood by considering the relationship between the output and input powers of the converter. The converter switches connect the DC input circuit directly to the AC output circuit. Thus, the net instantaneous power at the AC output terminal must always be equal to the net instantaneous power at the DC input terminal. So this is a basic VI characteristic of STATCOM. It is a large dynamic range, as its reactive power is a linear function of supply voltage. We know that Q equal to VI, right? So better reactive power support is there in this VI characteristics of STATCOM. The characteristics of a STATCOM reveals another strength of this technology, that it is capable of yielding the full output of capacitive generation almost independently of the system voltage. That means constant current output at lower voltage. See here, if your voltage is very less or low, STATCOM supply the constant current during the capacitive generation or capacitive reactance generation. And this capability is particularly useful for situation in which the STATCOM is needed to support the system voltage during and after faults, where voltage collapse would otherwise be a limiting factor. That means if your fault occurs, your voltage is deep or maybe very low. So at the time, with the help of STATCOM, you can supply in the constant current. Okay. The maximum attainable transient over current in the capacitive region is determined by the maximum current turnoff capability of the converter switches. This IC max, it is depends on the capability of a converter switches. In the inductive region, the converter switches are naturally commutated, and therefore the transient current rating of the STATCOM is limited by the maximum allowable junction temperature of the converter switches. So in this way, it is depends on the capability of converter switches, whereas in inductive region, it is depends on a maximum allowable junction temperature of converter switches. So this is a basic diagram of a STATCOM, which we have saw in earlier. So there is, if there is a fault quadrant, in first quadrant, your supply voltage and AC current, which is in phase. So it's supply for reactive power and active power. In second quadrant, it supplies the reactive power but absorbs the active power. In third quadrant, it absorbs reactive and real power. In fourth quadrant, it absorbs the reactive power and supplies the active power. So in practice, the semiconductor switches of the converter are not lossless. So the energy stored in the DC capacitor is eventually used to meet the internal losses of the converter, and the DC capacitor voltage diminishes. However, when the STATCOM is used for reactive power generation, the converter itself can keep the capacitor charged to the required voltage level. This task is as accomplished by mapping the output voltages of the converter leg behind the AC system voltages by a small angle. Normally, this angle is between 0.8 to 0.28. The range of this is 0.18 to 0.28. So in this way, the converter absorbs a small amount of real power from the AC system to meet its internal losses and keep the capacitor voltage at the desired level. The same mechanism can be used to increase or decrease the capacitor voltage and thus the amplitude of the converter output voltage to control the wire generation or absorption. More overload, the STATCOM has a more overload capacity, as capacitor is provided in the STATCOM. Both the end-to-end capacity regions of operations are possible if you use STATCOM flex controller. And STATCOM generate lower harmonics because of its generated at fundamental voltages. So these are some advantages of STATCOM. Thank you.